some of the main guys that people thought was the studs, and they never wanted to give me that to me because they knew what it was from the beginning. I asked for that fight before Rosado. They told me, oh, you win this fight, you beat Rosado, you gonna fight Canelo. And then I ain't fight Canelo, and guess what I did? Me, professionally, I wrote up a release myself to Golden Boy, and I sent it to him. It wasn't Al Heyman that said that. It's because they lied to me. They're not bad people. They just lied to me all my career.
Jermell Charlo came out recently responding to Oscar De La Hoya's comments of promoting him by stating, and I quote, "If y'all believe that shit, you a fool. 2012's I KO'd Chris Cutman in a 10-round fight, who was 15-1 at the time. Thank you, PBC, for saving us black fighters." He also continued by stating, "Back then, I could tell how much value Oscar De La Hoya had for us. We ran in the category of let's build them up to tear them down. But little did he know, I was a conscious fighter, ready to prove my worth. The risk was greater than the reward. His excuse is he had 100 fighters." I found it very interesting what Jermell stated, because I always say great minds think alike. Leos think alike. I told you all, if Jermell was food, Canelo Alvarez would have been for him. But Golden Boy and Canelo Alvarez both know what time it is when it came to Jermell Charlo. They know he the truth. You do not hunt down a lion, because the lion is the one that's doing the hunting. We pretty much know Canelo Alvarez looking for wounded fighters. So what makes you think he's gonna go after a lion? Jermell continued by stating, "Ain't no bouncing back when you're still doing the same thing to the current black fighters you got. Go ask any of them how they feel. Never mind. They will feel they biting the hands that's giving them bird seeds. But little do they know somebody willing to help them grow, Oscar De La Hoya." Now, I find it funny he said bird seeds. You usually hear somebody say, don't bite the hand that's feeding you. So Jermell pretty much letting y'all know, Oscar De La Hoya feeding people chump change, not what they actually worth. Jermell Charlo continued by stating, ain't no bitch over here. Can't nobody take me. I'm not you. I seen better for my career, and I was conscious enough and dipped so I can provide for my family. Then Charlo responded to a fan who stated, that's how Mexican must feel about Al Heyman, throwing Mikey with Spence and now talking about throwing Leo in with Tank. Shake my head. Charlo simply responded by stating, why you mad? Those are good matchup both parties want. Find another excuse. See, that's a decaf right there, because it was actually Mikey Garcia who was begging for that ass whooping by Errol Spence. When I first heard Mikey call out Errol Spence, I pictured a man trying to stand in the way of a train track. You know what will happen to that man? He will get crushed. He will get steamrolled, just like Errol Spence pretty much did Mikey Garcia. Now, Al Heyman actually advised Mikey Garcia not to take on the Errol Spence fight. He told him, I have better options for you. Mikey insisted he wanted to smoke with Errol Spence. So don't blame Al Heyman for what Mikey Garcia wanted. Al Heyman simply did Mikey a favor or two by delivering his request. And the same thing goes out to Cruz. He about to have the same fate, but he too begged Al Heyman for the fight. Matter of fact, Cruz loved Al Heyman so much, he named his son after Al Heyman. That's how much Cruz is thankful and grateful for having Al Heyman in his corner. Jermell continued by stating, you know I didn't give a fuck. I took what I could. When I fought Demetrius Hopkins, 33-1 at the time, the nephew to Oscar business partner June 6th, what was my chances? ? Odds was against me. Felt some type of way then, Oscar De La Hoya? I was 23 years old. Still made less than 100K. Let me tell you all something that motivated me when I was with Oscar De La Hoya and Golden Boy. They never signed my twin brother, and I always wanted to be promoted by the same company alongside of my twin brother. I was told the more I win, the bigger his chances of getting signed. That's absolutely ridiculous. So let's talk about it, because he said enough with that right there alone. So when it comes to Oscar De La Hoya, he definitely made a huge mistake when he signed one twin, but he didn't sign the other. Like I told y'all, they come with a package. You cannot sign one brother, but don't sign the other, especially when they pretty much have the same potential. It ain't like one look good on the eye test, but the other doesn't. Jermell Charlo, actually, from an early age, he was a beast. It ain't like he had to develop himself and then Oscar De La Hoya was like, you know what, if he prove himself, we signing him. Nah, he was a beast from day one. So like I said, it's just mind-boggling to me, like, for a promoter to see twins but sign just one of them. Like I said, they pretty much come in a package. So that was definitely wrong by Golden Boy. And they told Jermell, hey, listen, if you keep winning, then we signing your brother. What sense does that make? It ain't like they told Jermell, hey, listen, you keep winning on our undercards, you definitely getting signed. They told Jermell, if he keeps winning, he's getting signed. It all pretty much comes down to Oscar De La Hoya realizing, man, these two brothers, they beasts. So if I sign both of them, eventually they're going to have to fight Canelo Alvarez, and I'm not about to do Canelo dirty. That's why when Canelo didn't want to fight Charlo, even though he his own boss, right? So he told Oscar De La Hoya, nah, give me Crooklyn instead, the guy that's not from Texas, the guy that's coming off a year and a half layoff, the guy that got knocked out by a guy with six KOs. I'd rather fight him in Dallas instead of Jermell Charlo. So when Canelo Alvarez made that move and Golden Boy promised Jermell Charlo that he was going to get a Canelo Alvarez shot next, he was like, you know what? Just write me off my contract. And he, just like a boss, he left. It wasn't Al Heyman that told him, hey, come see us on PBC. It was actually Jermell Charlo's decision. So I just want to make one thing clear. You see so many black fighters complaining about Oscar De La Hoya and Golden Boy promotion when it comes to promoting black fighters. They say they don't get the love. Just like Errol Spence even told Oscar De La Hoya, I know you're trying to sign me, but you don't treat black fighters well, Oscar. They either don't get paid right, sit on the shelf, or don't get promoted right. On the other side, and on the other hand, Hispanic fighters, when it comes to BBC and Al Heyman, they got nothing but great things to say about Al. Like I said, Cruz named his son after Al Heyman. That's how much he thankful and grateful for Al. Abner Mares, on the other hand, he said he was locked up when he was fighting for Golden Boy. On some Akon, they didn't let him out. So all I'm pretty much saying is what's understood don't have to be explained. If you with Golden Boy and you happen to be black, I don't know, what are you doing? So, moving on to the next round. I appreciate everybody for tuning in. Split Decision episode 42 is over with. Subscribe below if you're trying to get smarter by the minute. If you're trying to get dumber by the second, don't. And listen to these decaps, a.k.a. dumb casual ass fans / old media that don't know shit about boxing. Word to Roger Mayweather. May he rest in peace. Like I said, I know these decaps hate to see Akhi on TV unless it's bad news. But I got bad news for y'all, because I'm always speaking the truth on the mic, and I know y'all don't have the cojones to even debate Akhi. If I had a lower IQ, I could have enjoyed y'all conversation.
They start messing with him, biting his tail, biting his ears. He doesn't do anything. The lioness, she starts messing with him, coming over, making trouble. Still, nothing. Now, the other animals, they notice this, and they start to move in. The jackals, hyenas, they're barking at him, laughing at him. Nip his toes and eat the food that's in his domain. They do this and they get closer and closer and bolder till one day that lion gets up and tears the shit out of everybody, runs like the wind, eats everything in his path. Because every once in a while, the lion has to show the jackals.